I am very happy to be here to address your opening session of your 22nd party congress now being held at Hyderabad. More particularly, I am very happy to take this opportunity to convey to our party revolutionary greetings on behalf of All India Forward Bloc founded by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. We frankly admit the CPIM is regarded as the most organized, largest party among the left parties in India. Obviously, the responsibility of the left leadership lies on CPIM. We earnestly hope that you will take all out efforts to strengthen the left unity, not only among the four left parties, but also should be a broader left unity taking care of all the left units in the country. Moreover, this broader left unity should be concentrated in a couple of states. It should be rather spread throughout the country. At present, political situation in our country is at a critical juncture. A vicious communal authoritarian force is now ruling at the center. It poses a threat to the national integrity and democratic values. A consolidated broad left unity can only combat this evil force. Our first and foremost necessity is strengthen the left unity. The progressive democratic secular forces in the country are awaiting the message from your party Congress. It is true that the ruling party BJP has got in absolute majority seats from the government, but at the same time it is fact BJP has got only 31% of the total votes. Hence, the majority of the adult population in the country are not with the ruling party BJP. A consolidated left force can share the huge remaining percentage of votes if they intensify their movement. Will the people for the people, the recent massive long march rally of the peasant of Maharashtra is a pointer to this. Moreover, Narendra Modi is now declining force in the eyes of the common people due to their failure in the majority sectors during the last 4 years. Rule of the center. In the most important factor, employment generation, they have miserably failed during 2014 Lok Sabha election campaign. Narendra Modi had promised 2 crore new jobs to the year, whereas the actual achievement is about 46 lakhs of job per year. The growing job-seeking young generation are therefore disappointed and aggrieved with the Modi government. The International Labour Organization predicted the increase of unemployment in country during the forthcoming 2 years. Unemployment is increasingly at the rate of 3.5% a year. This dismissal figure is due to the failure of the two vital field, agriculture and industry. The survey report of the international organization indicates 73% of the wealth is generated in India in 2017 goes only 1% of the rich people. In fact, the difference between the rich and the poor is increasingly every year. ILO estimated 1.86 jobless unemployed youths of India can derive any consolation from the Modi's explanation of a jobless growth. All these facts and figures are contrary to the Modi's claim that India is now achieving achadi. But for the dangerous food we caused after Narendra Modi came to the power, BJP and his associates like RSS, Vishwa Hindu Parishad, Bajrang Dal and other pursuing the policy of Hindutva, the essence of which dividing India on the basis of religion. The religion-based divisive form policy is contrary to Indian traditional history and culture to assimilate the various religious, caste, community and culture coming from outside during the several centuries. Narendra Modi and his RSS advisors are aiming to boost from India the minority community people like Muslims and other constitute about 1/5 of India's population. In the name of protection of the cow, they are oppressing the Muslim minorities. Even the Dalits are not safe in the hands. such a divisive policy will drag India into another partition of the country. This opposition left parties committed to oppose the Modi's Bhagwat divisive authoritarian activities. We look forward for the broader left unity for this purpose. All the progressive and democratic and secular in the country must unite together and push the communal authoritarian forces from the power. The question often arises whether it is feasible to strengthen the left unity forces, preferably through the alliance with the other parties. Some socialist parties are there, and as we are some regional democratic secular party, for the alliance their track records to be studied. Reviving the political history of India since independence, it is found that Congress is the main party which is arranged at the center for the maximum period. The result is not encouraging for the downtrodden people. They have introduced neoliberal economic policy in the country. The left parties in different states have all along fought against and safeguard the interest of the workers and peasants and the common people. Obviously, left parties are not inclined to have alliance with them, but there are a counter argument with the plea that fight against the enemy number one, BJP. All democratic parties should join hands, and such a lesser enemy, Congress, can be included for the alliance. But it appears the enemy is the enemy is the enemy. There cannot be any discrimination between number one, number two. We hope that in such a controversial issues, we may recall the United Left experiment in for installing the Congress-led UPA one government, with the left supporting such outside. But the main basis, there was a common minimum program which gives some dividends by the getting the enacted quite a few progressive bills. Why we should not think about and making a common minimum program, which would be the criterion for making alliance in the present political situation. However, I am not arguing to finalize anything on this issue. We prefer further discussion on this matter is required. We are confident that historic party Congress of the CPIM will certainly chart out a detailed strategy and strengthen the unity of the left, secure and democratic forces across the country. We are of the opinion that such a unity is need of the hour, when our great nation is being resurrected by the communal and divisive forces. Once again, we wish all success of the 22nd Party Congress of the CPIM and hope that this process of exchange of views will certainly strengthen the fraternal relation between our two parties, and we will be streamlined the process of left unity. I wish all success of your ongoing party congress with a revolutionary greeting. Jai Hind.